Hi everyone, welcome to OneX Labs, that's Lakshmi here. This course is all about how to clear Tableau Desktop Specialist certification. I have recently cleared my Tableau Desktop Specialist certification and I have been now a successful certified Tableau trainer. I have training experiences. I have been into this training industry for past 4 years. In this course, I'm going to completely explain how to prepare for this certification and how to clear this certification easily. So first, let's see how to enroll for this certification. So you can go to the Tableau certification page. There, you have to choose Tableau Desktop Specialist Certification because we have 3 levels of developer certification: Desktop Specialist, Certified Associate, Certified Professional. Desktop Specialist is the fundamental testing certification. So where you have to just have the knowledge of the basic fundamentals of Tableau. So you can easily prepare for this certification if you just have some few experiences with Tableau. And if you thoroughly prepare for this certification well, you can easily clear it. So first, you can go to the certification page. And now they are actually giving some offers for the certification. So this is a very low cost certification. Just for $100 they are providing this certification and it does not have any expiry. So you can register for this certification with the Loyalist Exam Services and you can choose the corresponding date and time. Or else you can also prepare yourself well for the certification and then you can register on the corresponding date. So they have given the exam preparation guide. So here you have all the idea like what type of things you have to prepare for this certification and what type of materials you need to follow for this certification. Okay, if you just prepare well about the concept which is being mentioned in this preparation guide, surely you can clear this certification. I'm going to explain you about each and every concept that has been specified in this exam preparation guide. Plus, I will share my experiences too. I have been into Tableau for past 5 years, but just I thought I will take up a certification as I don't believe much in certifications. But I tell Tableau certification, it's really a worth certification to take for because you have to prepare well for the certifications and the questions were not that easy where you can easily just clear this because it was very tricky. Only if you prepare each and every concept thoroughly and you have a well experienced hands-on knowledge. I'm talking about the very basic fundamentals, not the entire core concepts of Tableau. You just need to prepare the very basic fundamentals which have been specified here. If you prepare well, you can easily clear the certification. So today let me start how to create and save a data connection. That is the first topic, is connecting and preparing data. So how to create and save a data connection. So first of all, people who are very new to Tableau, let me tell you what is Tableau. So Tableau is a data visualization tool that has been widely used in the market and mainly it is a kind of tool where helps you to transform your data from any tabular format to a visual representation. And Tableau is one of the leading data visualization tools in the market. You can refer the Gartner's Magic Quadrant and it has been into the leader position for consecutively many years. So you can go to the Tableau website. Tableau has many products. Now we are going to focus only on the Tableau desktop. So you can click on the Tableau desktop. And you can click on the try it for free. And you can just download it by just giving your email ID. Since I have already logged in, it is automatically getting downloaded. So if you just give your email ID, then you can download the Tableau desktop which you have for 14 days trial. Apart from this, you can also have your Tableau public. So Tableau public is completely free of cost, which Tableau provides only for learning needs and knowledge sharing needs. You can go to Tableau public website and you can download the Tableau public. It is a cloud environment, but it is a non-secure environment. You cannot use any kind of secure data in Tableau public because it would be followed and seen by everyone who is connected to Tableau public. So you can use Tableau public only for your learning and knowledge purposes. So software wise, we don't have any concern. As I said, you have Tableau desktop, which gives you 14 days trial, as well as you have your Tableau public, which you can use it for lifelong and completely free version. So it has all the concepts, how you get the licensed version. Tableau public has the entire thing, which will be very sufficient for your learning. The only thing is, it is a cloud environment, where you cannot connect with your server related databases. You can connect only with your flat files. So now we will go for this concept, how to connect and prepare your data. So here, in order to connect, for example, if I am connecting with an Excel file, click on the Excel file. So you can click on any data which you want to connect. I'm connecting with my sample Superstore data. So once you connect to this particular data source file, you will be seeing the tables or the sheets connected with the corresponding file. In case you are connected with a flat file, you will be seeing the sheets. In case you are connected with any kind of server related databases, you will be seeing the corresponding databases. And once you choose the database, you could see the tables and views related to that particular database. So now we have connected to sample Superstore data. So you can pull the first table. So here, we are preparing how to create and save the data connection. So in that, create a live connection to a data source. So now I have connected with this sample Superstore data. So when you connect with any kind of data source, Tableau offers two types of connection. One is live, another one is extract. If you are connecting with your Tableau public, you cannot see that option because Tableau public is on cloud and we are not going to connect with any server related databases. So we don't have the option called extract here. It just connects your data with live when you connect with any kind of flat file. But when you connect a data source to a Tableau desktop, see, this certification is about desktop fundamentals. So certain concepts you have to learn with your desktop, you have to practice with desktop. As I said, the feature wise it is same, but see, it doesn't support server related databases, so you don't have the two types of connection like live or extract options here. It is everything live since you are connecting only to the flat files. Only when you connect your data source to the desktop version, you would be able to see these two types of connection. One is live, another one is extract. Okay. Now, let me explain you what is live and what is extract. See, when you are connecting to any type of data, so you can choose whether a live or a extract connection. When I say live, you are connecting directly with your data. Okay. When I say extract means there it creates a local copy and it is going to place that local copy in your local RAM file. Tableau supports in-memory analytics techniques where mainly to improve your performances. Because when we work on a real time, we may work with a data which is in huge volumes. In that cases, connecting on live sometimes may reduce your performances. So only to improve your performances, we are going for this extract connection. So in case of live, you're connecting directly with your data. So the speed of the data source, so how fast is your data source, the same speed will be reflected in your Tableau application also. So that's why, see, when you mouse over, you can read this. The speed of your data source will determine the performances. But when I click extract, so extract is nothing but it is going to create a copy of your original data, and that data will be placed in your local memory. Since the data resides in local memory, the performance will be faster. Also, when you switch from live to extract connection, where we are going to use the fast data engine connector, which is going to give you the tremendous improvement in your data when compared to the live. So there are wide reasons why you need to go for live and why we need to go for extract. So I'm going to explain you so the few reasons why you need to go for a live and why you need to go for an extract. Okay, so here I'm going to explain you, so like when you need to choose a live connection and when you need to go for the extract connection. See, for this topic, that is explain the difference using live connection, extract connection. So for this topic, you have to follow this particular URL. So if you just clearly read and understand this concept clearly, you will be getting two questions from this particular chapter. So you can easily clear it. I will be giving this link in the description. Kindly read that, and so that you can get any type of questions from this particular chapter. I'm also going to explain you a few concepts, but when you read it, you can read it like in a very detailed manner. So here we are going to understand between like when you need to go for a live and when you need to go for the extract connection. Okay. See, some data sources will not allow extracts, and where you have to choose only the live connection. Of course, it is a best practice we have to go for extract because it gives you faster performances, but certain type of data sources, it does not allow you to go for extract. So in that cases, we should definitely go for the live connections. Okay. And also, if you see, if your performance is more important when you are connecting a data source to Tableau, when you feel the performance is more important than the data freshness, you can go for extract. Because in extract, you are connecting only with the copy of your data. You are not connecting with the exact live data. So if any data changes are happening, only when you refresh, it is going to reflect in your extracts. But in live connection, it is not like that. If any data change is happening, it is going to immediately get reflected in your live connection. So, but when you are considering the performances is more important for your data than the freshness of your data, you go for the extracts. Okay. Extracts are great for enabling flow of your data analysis. So when you go for extract, definitely the performances will be better than the live connection. In case if you feel you need the real-time data is required for the business decision, in that cases we have to go for the live connection only. Okay. For example, if you see the stock exchange data, every minute the data will get changed. So in that cases, if I go for extract, definitely I will be missing some data. Even I cannot refresh my data for every seconds and every minutes. If I go for extracts, maybe I can do a refresh on a daily basis or even hourly basis is also okay. But doing a refresh on a minutes and seconds is not that easy. Again, it is also an another hindrance, like we have to handle with the refreshing times and all. So in that cases, if you need the data to be updated on time, if you need the real-time data for your business, definitely we have to go for the live connection than the extract connection. If your workbook contains sensitive data, or in that case is also you have to go for the live connection. Okay, in case when we are working with the very high level secure data, I cannot make the copy of the data and use it. Okay, in that cases, when we have those types of data, definitely we have to go for the live connection. When the performance of the extracts, comparing the performances, as I said, extracts give the better performances than the live connection. Again, it depends. I cannot say 100% this is correct. It depends. Okay, see, you, it, the word it depends. So it depends upon the data you connect. It depends upon the containers, how many visualizations you use. It depends upon the calculations you choose. It depends upon the filters you choose. Okay, sometimes extracts also may take time based on the data we connect, and also like how much visualizations we have, complex level of calculations, and also the kind of filters we use. That may also affect your performances. Okay, so you have to understand the clear difference connecting to a live connection and connecting to a extract connection. So in the next video, we will talk more about extracts. Thanks for listening to the video. Thank you.